Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, we have seen that after putting these statements, that is, remember mutable state of, we were able to successfully update the composable UI. So there is something about this that ensures that the composable function gets invoked every time the state changes. You can actually verify this by writing a statement below here and see whether it executes or not. And let me rerun the application. So as you can see here, this gets invoked when the composable gets called is the log statement that you are seeing here. Let me put dot value here, and every time I click on increment, this gets invoked when the composable gets called again, is getting invoked again and again, along with of course the lambda invocation that is happening. So this just proves the point that to be able to render the UI state appropriately, the composable function needs to get called properly. If I just write normal counter and run this again, you will see that first time this line is getting executed, but after I increment every time, only lambda is getting called, and this gets invoked when composable gets called is not getting logged. And that is the reason why you see that the state is not changing. So let's revert this particular code. Now the obvious question that you might be having is, what does this remember and mutable state of actually do? So let's just concentrate on mutable state of value 0. Mutable state of makes it possible for the composable to listen to the changes that are happening to the state. So it is basically acting as a setting of a listener. Because for the composable to render the updated state, it needs to be aware that its state has changed. So mutable state of is doing the work of setting a listener to the state from the composable's perspective, so that composable can get notified when the counter's value changes, that is, its state changes. So that is about mutable state of. And what about this remember? Well, remember makes it possible for the composable to remember its old state. What do you mean by old state? If it is getting incremented to 1, its old state was 0. If it is incremented to 2, its old state was 1. So without knowing what was its previous state, the composable cannot come to know that its state has changed. So a composable should have a capability to remember its previous state, and remember makes that possible. Let me demonstrate this particular point. What I will do is I will remove this remember and let me run the code. And if you see here in the logcat, this gets invoked is there. And if I increment, then the function is getting called again, but it doesn't know what its previous state is. So it is always getting initialized to 0. So that is the reason why no matter how many times you click on increment, the function is getting invoked, but the state is not getting changed. And even not only that, if you write the remember, but don't write the mutable state of and only just write 0. Let's do the appropriate changes here and let me rerun the code. This also won't work. If I run this, counter value 0, once again counter value 1, counter value 3, 4, 5. Basically, this is not getting executed again. Because if you don't write mutable state of, that basically means composable has no capability to listen to the changes that are happening to the state. So this remember and mutable state of are like Siamese twin. They always work together. Now that I have fixed it, you will observe that it is once again working perfectly fine. There is a scenario where you can avoid using remember. We will see that in the later video. But there is a way we can refactor this code and improve this to some extent. Everywhere we are writing counter.value plus 1, counter.value. Everywhere we are being forced to use this template, counter.value, which just makes it look very cumbersome. If we could simplify this and be able to use it as a normal variable, it would have been much better. Well, you can do that. Instead of equal to, you can write by. So now this counter can be accessed as if it was a not a mutable state, but a normal variable. And this code looks much, much better. So by is a delegate function, which allows you to do this. And now let me rerun this particular code, and this will still work exactly the way we want it to work.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.